gets knocked back.
Yeah, and that'd be tough, wouldn't it?
But you all work so hard. For no thanks.
You're going to laugh on the other side of your face by the time the council's finished with you.
Oh, yeah? Who says?
I do. You didn't just hurt Lexi, you hurt all of us with what you did.
And how did I manage that?
We proved to the screws that we could do things for ourselves. We got the council going and classes. It only takes one troublemaker like you to stuff it all up. You're not going to stuff it up again. And in case you're wondering, she's speaking for all of us. We've had a gutful.
Yeah, that's wrong.
Oh. And nobody gives a stuff whether I did it or not, right? You're just looking for a fall guy.
She sucked you into a bloody stupid dream.
You're wrong, Lou. What Nora's doing is worthwhile. She's working for all the women, not just herself.
Lexi's an ungrateful little bitch, sure. But at least she's trying to make something of her life.
Daphne, what's that?
What?
You've brought two tins of tomato soup. I didn't ask for soup, dear.
Didn't you, sure?
I'm sure. I asked for three tins of tomatoes. Now, fresh ones would be better, of course, but when I finish, no one will realise.
No, I'm sure you said soup.
Oh, I may as well do it all myself.
No, it's all right. I don't mind, Lily. What was it again?
Oh.
Bertram, as you seem to be in charge here, I'll leave my little mate Keane with you. If that's all right with Keane, I'm sure she'll be quite safe.
Oh, yeah, I'll be fine. Whatever you say.
You're not nervous, are you, Keane? Because if you are, I could always take you to Sister Hall. She could give you an injection to calm you down.
No, no, I'll be all right. I'll get used to it, see?
That's the spirit. You can get used to anything in here.
Well, where's Ray?
Who?
Ray the cook. Where's the cook?
Oh, there's no Ray here. Merv's our cook. He's doing a cooking competition, a real big one. It's going to be on telly.
You met him this morning in the dining room with Mrs. Barry?
Yeah, don't remember.
No, of course you don't, dear. Now, how would you like to chop some vegetables for me while you figure it out? You do remember vegetables, don't you?
Honey May.
Are awfully quiet.
Look, I don't want to talk about it, all right?
Yeah, neither would I if I'd blown me only chance.
Yeah, it's too bad you're getting too big for your boots.
Look, it's all your fault it was wrecked in the first place, so shut up, Kelly.
I just say, if you're going to do something, you might as well do it right.
I'm going to bloody well kill
hey,
you.
Hey, come on, come
get off!
Kelly!
Get off me, fat guts!
Come on, I'll take on the two of you. You've lost a friend. What's the matter? You're afraid to face me one-to-one? Some bloody top dog. You're all talk and no action.
I'll fight you any day, Kelly. The only problem is, I might go too far.
Mervyn, help me with these, would you, Penny?
Oh, sorry,
it's all right. It doesn't matter. Here, we better check that we've got everything.
Oh, I don't know. Look, Josie, I don't think I can do this. I'm worried about the women doing all my work for me today, and what happens if...
Mervyn Pringle, the women have managed without a cook before. I'm quite sure they'll manage now.
Well, I suppose so.
What are you looking for?
I don't believe it.
What are you looking for?
My herbs, my secret herbs, I can't find
Mervyn,
them. I can't cook without them, Mervyn, Josie.
Mervyn, we put them in the car last night so we wouldn't forget them, don't you remember?
Yes, of course, look, I'm sorry. Josie.
What?
Josie.
Oh, Mervyn! Oh, no! Oh, God! What do I do? What do I do? Put something soft under the patient's head? Oh, I don't know. Never! Oh, no!
That's better.
Thank goodness you're all right. I was so worried I'd do something wrong. Forget those instructions.
You were wonderful. I suppose I'd better contact the organisers and tell them I won't be coming.
But you're feeling all right now, aren't you?
Physically, yes, but I don't think I could cope with all that pressure so soon after the attack. I have to be 100% when I cook. All that competition.
But I'll be there helping you, and if you get into any trouble, you can just ask me.
But it's the way you cook that's important, not what you cook. It involves a certain frame of mind, a mental approach. I don't think I'm quite up to it.
Oh, but it seems such a shame after all that preparation.
Well, I'll buy you a microwave if that's what you're worrying about.
Oh, Mervyn Pringle, I'm surprised at you. It's not the oven I care about.
And how many times have you told me about your Auntie Hazel and how she spared nothing to put you through cookery school? What would she think now if she heard you saying this?
Well, I'd have a go if it wasn't for the attack.
Oh, well, it's your decision, of course. I don't want to force you into anything. Everyone's going to be so disappointed. Mrs. Reynolds, Meg, all the women. And, of course, the prisoners, too. But if you feel you're not up to it, I suppose I'd better start putting this lot away. You'd better phone the organisers and tell them you're not coming.
No. Don't unpack yet. Maybe we could...
Oh, it's far too late now, dear. We'd never get to the television station before the programme starts.
Yes, we could. If we were quick, you phone them and tell them we've been delayed, and I'll put this lot in the car.
Oh, well, whatever you say, Mervyn. It's your decision.
I'm still as nervous as hell, but I'm doing it for you.
Okay, all the intros on camera one. When you walk out, the contestants, camera two will pick you up.
Fine.
All right, no worries. Go down in 30 seconds. Standby, studio.
Listen, what am I going to say about that guy that hasn't turned up?
Look, I'll tell him they got stuck in traffic, mate. Tell him anything.
Looks like them now.
I've just got time to get him into place. Go back to original script.
Oh, look at all these lights.
Oh, it's like an oven in here.
Mr. Pringle.
Oh. I'm very sorry we're late.
That's your area over there. 15 seconds to air. Stand by. We're just about to start the program. Go and set up your stuff. Bob will come and talk to you as soon as he does his opening patter, OK?
We're sorry we're late, but we thought...
Oh, look, there's Bob Michaels. Oh, I thought he'd be taller than that.
Better do what we're told and get ready.
Don't worry, it'll be all...
Quiet on the set. 10 seconds to air. Final's rolling. Go ahead. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Good afternoon and welcome to the program again. We have got a great show as usual. We'll be crossing live to Adelaide to talk with a man who breeds snails to eat. We'll also have a song from one of our regulars, the lovely Marina Todd. But first up, as I promised to you yesterday, we have some gentlemen who really know what they're doing in the kitchen. And throughout the program today, we're going to be conducting the, let me get this right now, the Australian Home Cookery Course Competition. Now, if you think that's a mouthful, wait till the end of the program when we bring in our very special guest, Peter Russell Clark, who'll have a few mouthfuls of food and he will judge just who is to be the chef of the year. So, without any further ado, let's go across and meet the contestants, eh? Here we go. $3,000 to the winner, a microwave oven, and a magnificent trophy for the efforts. First cab off the rank, Francois Capri.
Hello, Mr. Michaels.
You have just come back from Canada.
Yes, I won silver medal at the Vancouver Gastronomique Festival.
Congratulations. Oh, I must mention, too, that Francois has won this competition 2 years running. So good luck today, Francois.
Thank you. It is a pleasure to be on your program again.
The pleasure is all ours, believe me. Next off is
Jonathan Edgley.
Jonathan, I believe you're head chef at the Seafood Cave.
Yes, and might I add, it's the finest seafood in town.
Oh, I can second that. I really can. It is beautiful. Yes. Also believe that you've worked at the famous restaurant in Paris. That's the Bon Appetit.
Such a wonderful experience.
Well, good luck today, Jonathan.
Oh, thank you.
Now, our final contestant is...
Pringle, Mervyn, this is my assistant, Mrs. Barry.
I've always wanted to meet you.
Well, thank you very
much. Sorry we're late.
Yeah, actually, they got caught up in traffic. But listen, my researcher here says that you are a cook at a prison of all places.
Yes, Wentworth.
Yeah, well, you would be at an advantage.
Pardon?
Well, you'd have a captive audience to try your recipes on.
Yeah, I suppose I would have.
Well, I suppose...